Respectful dear family members, my pranams to you. Last day we were discussing about Mahabharata. You know our Puranas and Mahabharata, they were all written in Naimisharanya. What's meant by Naimisharanya? Where is the place and how that name came for that part? Remember that Naimisharanya is the present Nimasar district of Haryana. Nimasar district of Haryana. The old name of Nimasar district, old name is Naimisharanya. It was an open university. Many, many scholars used to visit Naimisharanya. They used to stay there and deliver lectures. That was the first open university in the world. Thousands of students were studying there. Hundreds of teachers were teaching there in different subjects. The most interesting thing was that almost every day, whenever the guest comes, the guest can be kings, emperors, great scholars, great professors, or even great rishis, acharyas, and so on. Anybody who has got really scholarly background. They used to stay in the guest house of Naimisharanya, and after the evening food, according to Ayurveda, almost before sunset, the evening food will be over. There is nothing like a dinner or supper. And after that food, they perform their good way of performing Sandhya Vandanam, Jabam, Veda Parayanam. After that, generally they used to come to the auditorium. Many students and many scholars will be watching there, sitting there as audience. This Naimisharanya lecture is fully question answer lectures. The question will be first starting after the introduction about the king or the scholar. After that introducing personality from the university Naimisharanya requests the scholar, the visitor, to explain where he was coming, where he was going, and what is his background, what is the purpose of his visit, and what is his background, and so on, from where he could collect all this information, and so on. You know, in olden days, either horse cart or bullock cart or something like that used to be there. So the movement, the traveling, the pilgrimage, etc., used to be very slow. Days and days of travel used to be there. So they used to stay more days also in Naimisharanya, and it is almost free for the scholars, for the kings and other thing, because Naimisharanya used to work with the support of the kings and other scholars. So when the people come there, the scholars come there and they deliver lecture, a group of students or a group of readers or lecturers, need not be professors at lower level, they used to note down the points, the questions asked by the students and by the staff, and the answers given by the scholars, by the guest. That used to be noted down. Naimisharanya has got that culture. Questions from the students and from the audience, the answers from the scholar. This used to be written. The question can go to any direction. Any direction, even suddenly it can jerk from one subject to another subject. Full freedom used to be given. And the students generally, who notes down all this point, appears that they are from Vedavyasa Kula, Vedavyasa Gotra. Vedavyasa, Vyasa Gotra. And finally, what will be happening? All these notes, questions and answers, used to be compiled, and it will be continued. and the Vyasakula scholars, rishis compile it, edit it and publish it as Puranas, 18 Puranas and 18 Upapuranas. Sometimes more and more guests who are delivering lecture on the same subject can be, thus lectures and the questions answers can be combined in one Purana. You know, Skanda Purana is perhaps the biggest Purana, very big Purana, Skanda Purana. Even though we do not have that much knowledge about Skanda Purana, even its content connected with the Subramanyam and so on. So you know, 18 Puranas and 18 Upapuranas were written as question answers and composed, edited in Naimisharanya. Exactly like that, this Mahabharata was also written in Naimisharanya as such questions and answers, and it goes deep into variety of subject. Need not be straight from A to Z. It can be A, then C, then again B, or it can go to Z, it can go to K, and like that. It goes the straight national highway. Sometimes it may be going to some other gullies and other thing, narrow roads and other thing, again coming back to the main road. Whereas Ramayana is not like that. Ramayana is starting point to end point straight, written in 24,000 shlokas, based on 24 letters of Gayatri Mantra. Gayatri Mantra has got 24 letters, and 24 letters got converted into 24,000 shlokas. Yesterday I explained almost about Mahabharata. It's a huge book, a very big book, 125,000 shlokas. But remember that it's not necessary that you have to study everything in Mahabharata. You can read the abstract of that, outline of that, learn the stories and experiences of Pandavas and Kauravas, and then utilize that knowledge for improving yourself and also those who are connected with you. So remember that it is not must that you have to strictly read, just like the Christians read Bible, just like the Muslims read Quran, or Buddhist Dharmavada, or Guru Granth Sahib by the Sikh. Our Mahabharata is not that type of book. It's only for learning itihasa. It's a historical book where, as I told you in the last class, vidhi and vidhi nishedam sardar, simple way. Vidhi means the messages, the experiences that the reader should follow or try to follow in their life. Not for going to heaven, not for preventing from going to hell, but to make your life heavenly, that's all. Make your life heavenly, we have to learn as much as possible the vidhi given in Mahabharata and avoid the vidhi nishedam, that is the negative experiences, negative messages that we come across when we are reading Mahabharata, that you avoid it. Vidhi, you take it. And now I told you last classes that Puranas are the basic, through stories conveying the messages. Puranas are stories connected with kings, queens, ordinary people, rishis, and so on. When you come to the next higher level, it is experiences of Pandavas and Kauravas and all those who are associated with them in 65,000 shlokas, mixed with the stories of 60,000 shlokas of animals and birds, reptiles, and so on. Now, when you in Hinduism, Hindu Dharma, when you go one more step above Valmiki Ramayana, I told you earlier, it is not written in Naimisharanya. It is separately written in the bank of Tamasa River. Tamasa Nadi, and written the, and it starts from a point one to the last. It is in fact the biography of Rama, not autobiography, biography of Rama. So naturally all those who are connected with the Lord Rama will be coming there, will be part of the Ramayana. So remember that it is the biography of Sri Rama. A little bit exaggeration can be there, a story type presentation can be there, and those who are reading the Ramayana can do addition, deletion, modification, and according to their own interest they can slightly modify. But the prime theme of Valmiki Ramayana is written by Valmiki. And you may be knowing that there are about 250 or more than that Ramayana written in Kerala. And the Kamba Ramayana, and there are so many 300 Ramayanas are written in Tamil Nadu. And 300 or something like that Ramayana written in Karnataka, 350 or Ramayanas written in Telugu, and so on. Because you have got the freedom to do addition, deletion, modification and correction. According to the local situation, you can modify them so that people with devotion, dedication and sincerity can go through that one and take, as I said earlier, the vidhi and also vidhi nishedam. Whatever good thing you can take from all the characters, we can see connected with the Rama, Lord Rama, there are about prominent 20 characters are there. Prominent 20 characters. Dasharatha, 3 wives, 4 children, 8, and Vasishta, 9, then Bali Sugriva, then 11, then Ahalya, Jadayu, Sambadi, and coming to Ravana, Kumbhakarna, Vibhishana, Indrajit, Hanuman, Sugriva, and almost 20 powerful, strong players are there in the epic, which is also known as Adikavyam. The importance of Ramayana, we should understand, everyone should understand the importance of Ramayana is that the person who wrote that Ramayana, he got himself converted from a burglar state of mental and physical level to a greater rishi. A burglar got converted into a rishi. So in our Vedas it is told the ultimate goal of the life is asadoma sadgamaya, from bad to good, good to better, better nearer to the best. The ultimate experience of the life is that when we have to move, we should not be stagnant. Stagnation is death, death is stagnation. Life is growth, growth is life. So we have to move from bad to good, mentally, psychologically, economically, physically, and spiritually, and take for that matter socially, any economically, scientifically, technologically. The ultimate goal of the life of an individual, family, culture, society, nation is moving from bad to good, moving from lower level to higher level. Asadoma Satyamaya and Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya, from darkness to light, from a state of ignorance to a state of knowledge. Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya and Mrityorma Amritamgamaya, from a tensionful life to tensionless life. This is what is explained in the life of Rama, in the biography of Rama, Ramayana. There can be many questions, but many people may not believe some of these things. Many exaggerations are there. And in all these cases, why, what, when, where, who, whom, how, 7 questions can be asked. Why it happened, when it happened, how it happened, where it happened, to who is responsible for happened, to whom it happened, and what happened. Our role when we read Ramayana is to get the answer what happened and how I can make use of that in my life management. What happened there? Why Rama said like that to Lakshmana, Bharata or Shatrughna or Vibhishana? Why he said is not important. What he said is important, how it can be connected with my life, my family life, my social life, and how I can do addition, deletion, modification and correction if needed. Because those messages and those experiences are from Treta Yuga, thousands and thousands of years past this happened. So remember, Exactly the same thing cannot be copied by me in this period. So what should be done? You do addition, deletion, modification, and correct. And Ramayana also, as I told you little bit earlier, Vidhi and Vidhi Nishedha. What are the things to be taken from Ramayana for making your life useful, purposeful, fruitful, meaningful, for making our life glorious, for a great life, a glorious life, a noble life, for a fantastic, useful life, right from the date of birth till the last date of breath. If we can make our life little by little comfortable and useful every day, for which our mind should change. If the mindset changes, thoughts will change. When the thoughts changes, action will change. Our life is the combination of mind, thoughts and action. Good mind, good thoughts, good action. And bad mind, bad thoughts, bad action. A fearful mind, fearful thoughts, fearful action. A pessimistic mind, pessimistic thoughts, pessimistic action. I think now it is clear for you. So from the negative mind, if you can convert the mind into positive, that's the use of Valmiki Ramayana. If you have got devotion, dedication and sincerity to read that, it's merely reading, you will not go to heaven. It's not for going to heaven, it's not preventing to go from going to hell, but creating a heaven in this world and preventing the creation of a hell in this world. How to live in a family? How to keep a mind, a good mind? How to keep a good, excellent family relation between wife and husband, father and mother, children, brothers, and so on? This is what we learn. How to keep a good relation, how to avoid keeping bad relation, and how to avoid the surgence of bad things in our home. It is a really psychological analysis, comparative psychological analysis, CPA, comparative psychological analysis. What happened to Bali and why that is Bali Sugriva fought? What happened to Vibhishana? What happened to Kumbhakarna? What happened to Indrajit? What happened to Ravana? What happened to Mandodari? You just ask what happened and why it happened. What happened and why it happened? Then you have learned Ramayana. The answer is with you. You need not even go to Ramayana. Why Rama had to go to forest? What was the theme behind that? Why Kaikeyi said like that? What is the role of Mandara? What is the role of Dasharatha? And what is the role of Vasishta? And just you ask and find out the answer. Others may be giving their own opinion. You may be knowing that Malinowski, one of the great historian, sociologist, historian of Russia, Malinowski has mentioned that history is not really what happened. Anyway, the history of France or French Revolution or Russian Revolution or Indian independence, the history of these, if you are reading in a book, it's not really the history with the fact, truth and figures, but it is the opinion of that particular historian. It is the opinion and vision and viewpoint of that particular historian who is explaining to you about the French Revolution, Russian Revolution or Indian independence. The truth and fact may be different, some of them may be here also. Like that, Valmiki Maharshi, being a strong role player in Ramayana, explained to you, these are all the things happened in Ramayana. You cannot argue with that, because past materials are given to you. You cannot ask why Rama divorced Sita or just threw away Sita. The answer is simple. If you think Rama did the correct thing, you can also follow like that. If you think Rama did the wrong thing, you don't follow that. Very simple. If you behave like Ravana, you will be getting the experience partly of Ravana. Exactly like that. So I need not teach you Ramayana. I am giving you an outline of Ramayana. I am not explaining Ramayana. I am just telling you how to look into Ramayana, the great Indian literature. So, unlike the Christians and Muslims, we have got thousands of literature and thousands of commentaries, thousands of sub-commentaries, all these written by thousands of rishis or great scholars. And remember that thousands of subjects are there in those books, and thousands of years took to compile all those things. So remember that we have to utilize those knowledge which are suitable for the 21st century. Remember that we are not living in Treta Yuga. We are living in, need not bother about Kali Yuga or not, we are living in 21st century. So we have got a strong modern background, a powerful academic background, those who are listening this one, or those who are reading Ramayana. So accordingly, any knowledge, any information, any experience of any people, you have to suitably make it adoptable and adaptable for us. Adoptable and adaptable for us. Then march forward. Then you march forward. Take the good from that. That is what is my business. Experience of Mahindra and Mahindra. Experience of Toyota production system, TPS. Experiences of Ford production system, FPS. Experiences of General Electrical Company. Experiences of Tata. And experiences of Nokia. You can see experiences of the people producing different types of products. Different type of management, material management, quality management, personal management, time management, and raw material management, storage management, space management, and human resource development and management. You are managing different things in your life, for which if some of these factors are useful for you, then excellent. How Rama Lakshmana gave the responsibility of constructing the Sedu from India to Lanka, Sedu Bandhanam, utilizing every individual, whether a squirrel or a monkey or Hanuman or Jambavan, or for that matter Vibhishana or anybody. See, amandram aksharam nasti nasti moolamanaushadam ayogya purusho nasti yojagata taradurlaba. You can make mantras using any letter. You can make medicine using any plant. You can use any individuals. But the thing is that you should have the quality to use the letters to make mantras, to write mantras. You should have the quality to make medicine from the plant products. You should have the quality to utilize the people available for you. So if suitable people are not available, you find his merits and quality and give him suitable work. Suitable work to suitable people. You may not get the suitable person for everything at every time, any instance. This is what we have to learn. It's not chanting Rama Nama and other things. That also is good, not bad. But utilizing the technique used by our Rama, Lakshmana, Bharata, Shatrughna, Ravana, or anyone for their marching forward in Treta Yuga. And also 18 days of battle in Mahabharata and the messages of Bhagavad Gita. Utilize Bhagavad Gita. You know Bhagavad Gita, one issue of Harvard Business Review, HBR. Harvard Business Review, one full issue was on Gita becomes the new management mantra for the big business community in US. Gita becomes the new mantra for the big biz in US. So they have taken Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita was written or advised to Arjuna by Lord Krishna during 3140 BC. 3140 BC, about 38 years prior to the beginning of Kali Yuga. So 5161 years over, 51 century, 51 and a half century over after composing Bhagavad Gita. But they utilize that as a management technique in Harvard University. It's one among the papers the students should learn dharma based management. And this is the thing. So not utilizing as such what was composed in about thousands of years, but making it adoptable and adaptable in the 21st century and utilizing it. So now remember that Ramayana, every part of Ramayana, I used to say whenever I deliver lecture on Ramayana, you have got a big cake. You cut it and make it small pieces and give to different people. Now Ramayana is just like a big cake. You cut it and make a small piece of events, small piece of event, small piece of messages, small story there in Ramayana. Even if it is there, it is part of history. Unlike Mahabharata, stories are not there in Ramayana. If at all some stories are mentioned, it is not story, it is part of history about their forefathers. So take each piece of Ramayana. Either it will be the experience or it will be the message. Then listening, analyzing and assimilating, watching, analyzing and assimilating, discussing, analyzing and assimilating, thinking, analyzing and assimilating. And remember that you can definitely get a lot from that. Your knowledge in front of you is about the knowledge of the 200 years of modern science. The knowledge behind you, 180 degree, is the knowledge of the experiential knowledge of our forefathers, available plenty in our motherland, available plenty in our motherland. But all other civilizations and cultures got erased off. Nothing can be available from that. But as fresh as the new, Chira Puradhanam plus Nitya Nodhanam is equal to Sanatanam. Chira Puradhanam, older than the oldest, and Nitya Nudanam, ever novel. That is Sanadhanam, that is the Sanadhana Dharma. In that Sanadhana Dharma, you can get a lot. You scientifically, logically, rationally analyze it. Whether you are a Christian, Muslim, or a Hindu, whether you are leftist, rightist, or Middle East, don't worry about it. If it is useful, take it. If you take it, you are not going to go to the heaven. If you don't take it, you are not going to go to the hell. But creating a heaven in this world and avoiding as much as possible the negative experiences of the hell in this world, Ramayana will be helpful for you. And every event, you take an individual, Kaikeyi, what she said, what happened in Ramayana. If you are practicing the messages or the experiences of Kaikeyi in your life, what will happen? Simple, as simple as that. Thus, it's very important for the Hindus to learn Ramayana, and we in Kerala particularly used to read Ramayana during the Karkidaka month. During that period in Treidayuga, Ramayana was composed and chanted by Leva and Kusha to in front of their father, Lord Rama, in Ayodhya. Those days we are remembering here. So remember that learning Ramayana, each experiential knowledge and teaching to others as suitable for the 21st century is my duty and your duty. Now during this corona period and also other problematic period, we have got enough time. Social media is flourishing. Utilize the social media to educate others also. With these words, half an hour I would like to conclude my message to you. Thank you very much. My pranams to you.